Shri Radhe, Jai Jai Shri Radhe, Jai Jai Shri Radhe. हम लोग अब आज की कार्रवाई का शुभारंभ करते हैं और मैं अनुरोध करता हूं हमारे नेशनल प्रेसिडेंट फॉर्मर गवर्नर पद्म विभूषण डॉक्टर टी एन चतुर्वेदी जी कृपया मंच पर आए आसन ग्रहण करें। अग्रवाल जी से चेयरमैन ऑफ पुष्पांजलि ग्रुप चेयरमैन ऑफ द पुष्पांजलि हॉस्पिटल एंड ही हैज गॉट ए सच ए रिमार्केबल अचीवमेंट्स मोर देन 100 कॉलोनीज हैज बीन कंप्लीटेड मोर देन 10,000 हाउसेज एंड फ्लैट्स हैज बीन कंप्लीटेड एंड ही हैज गॉट मैनी फेदर ऑन हिज हेड Dr. B.D. Agarwal, Working Chairman of Respected International. मैं अनुरोध करता हूं मिस्टर एन एन गौतम से ही इज अवर पार्टनर मिस्टर एन एन गौतम प्लीज ही हैज बीन टू द मॉरिशस एंड ही इज ऑल्सो कनेक्टेड विद मैनी एसोसिएशन मिस्टर एन एन गौतम मैं गौरव गुप्ता जी से अनुरोध करता हूं कृपया आए और मंच पर अपना स्थान लें इज ए डायनेमिक पर्सन राजस्थान एकेडमी इज ए प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ मैनी क्लब इंक्लूडिंग अलायंस क्लब मिस्टर गौरव गुप्ता और मैं अनुरोध करता हूं डॉक्टर सुशील चंद्रा जी से He is an advisor, former advisor to Government of India. He has been the director of many organizations, prominent organizations of India, and he is a force with us to organize big functions. Dr. Sushil Chandra, please come and take the dice. The other members. Are on the way and without waiting further we want to and I am requesting Kamla ji she has come all the way from USA please come join on the dais as a guest of honor and Dr. Sushil Chandra ji please escort her up to the dais Subhas Lakhotia ji is welcome here. He is a past governor and a dynamic force. And I also request from Palestine Embassy, the counselor, please come as a guest of honor to this function. Thank you. The time is running short, so without waiting, we want to get the position and want to start with the national anthem. Please start the national anthem, and all are requested to please stand.
जन गण मन अधिनायक जय है भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्रावड़ उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्छल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तब शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तब जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय है भारत भाग्य विधाता जय है जय है जय है जय 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 है
our chief guest and the dignitaries on the dais please come and light the lamp so that we can start the function
vakratund mahakal surya koti samaprabha nirvighnam kurme सर्वकार्येषु
Welcome to R.N. Lakhotia ji. He is also one of the awardees. Thank you very much for your coming. हमारे बीच में हैं डॉक्टर गिरीश चंद्रा. He has come all the way from the UK. डॉक्टर गिरीश चंद्रा. He is also a national awardee of the previous year. Amongst us is a former private secretary to president of india mr kc jain rajan please stand please and thank you and we have with us mr sardari lal ji he is the chairman of the council of the senior citizens east delhi mr sardari lal ji please thank you please come on the front row mr sardari lal ji आप आगे आइए प्लीज कम एंड ही टेकिंग आउट न्यूज पेपर ही टेकिंग आउट सीनियर सिटीजन वॉइस ऑफ सीनियर सिटीजन इट इज वेरी पॉपुलर न्यूज पेपर मोर देन 11,000 कॉपीज आर सर्कुलेटेड इन ऑल द सीनियर सिटीजन एसोसिएशन इन दिल्ली एंड ही इज द फाउंडर ऑफ दिस न्यूज पेपर एंड वी हैव अमंगस्ट अस सो मेनी सीनियर सिटीजन हु इज लिविंग in a senior citizen home which is established by Mrs. Ansal, Kusum Ansal ji. So we welcome to you all and there are so many dignitaries are with us at the moment and I will introduce them in time to time. Mr. Vedpal Gupta is also here with us. We welcome to you, V.P. Gupta ji. And now I request our national president to have the welcome speech. Padma Vibhushan K.N. Chaturvedi. Abab, he is coming here.
Very distinguished colleagues, friends on the dais and in front, and particularly the awardees in today's function. Respect Age India International has been a very pioneering organization, and today with respect, we remember its founder, Dr. Hari Krishna Gupta. As you are all aware, the idea that the senior citizens' significance in society does not either decline, disappear, or gets extinguished with increasing age, increasing years, is a question of growing older and older. And it's not a question of growing old, but it's a question of growing older and older. That is why It is said that the senior citizens are a storehouse of experience. Experience, a variety of different kinds, different types, and in depth over the years. And it is this experience which can enable them to guide even the present. Those who are in charge of the affairs today. It's not necessary that one should always be at the steering wheel, but the problem remains as to how one should function. This can certainly be helped. This kind of an advice can be given, not just while sitting near the person who is in the steering wheel or behind, but through sage advice, so sagacious advice that this is the way if one functions, then it is up to you how you want to do the things. This is up to you and this person to decide. But then that treasure trove of experience certainly can be of great assistance. And similarly, sometimes there is the adverse, the situation also. Though I find that most of the awardees and the colleagues, the senior citizens who are here present, they are even today contributing their best to the society in different ways, not necessarily in the manner that they might have done it earlier, but they are doing it in different ways. But it does happen quite often among senior citizens with increasing years that they develop a sense of futility, a feeling that they are not in a position any longer, or sometimes they also become much too interfering with the coming generations and so on. So that is also which has to be avoided. We have also to ensure that it is the new generation, the new people, the younger people, and they have to come, and that is an inevitable fact of life, something to be welcomed. And then the guidance has been provided, but then there should not be some kind of a feeling even amongst them that we are needlessly interfering. Many times I have found among friends and relations and so on and so forth that the son and the father, the relations that they should have, somehow or the other there is a deviance from that kind of relationship. And the only thing one finds is that each of them has the respect and affection, consideration, and also the understanding of the ability, but somehow or the other the younger one feels that the father or the senior is interfering too much, too at every stage. That is another the problem. Fortunately, we find that, as I said, that the people who are here, the awardees, they are contributing, and that they provide the illustration, an example to all of us in society as to how one should function. Dr. Gupta has been a very enthusiastic worker in the cause of ensuring that the senior citizens have a respectable place, a place of dignity, of understanding, and also of usefulness. And that's why he has devised a number of the programs and so on. But so far as this program is concerned, this is a very important one and a very significant one. It is in the sense that it enables the society to pay gratitude to those who have been contributing and who have served as a role model and who can serve as a role model for future to come. It's not something that the society, our they respect Age India International when we just give the awards, is this honors, and it itself is honored, because this is the our tradition has been that we should respect all those who have contributed to society in the different ways and have also projected themselves, not just by as a way of showmanship, but in the normal course of their working as the model, because this is what is unfortunately very much lacking, and that's why there is a need for understanding. And apart from that, the government also is very much concerned, at least through laws, etc., etc. But then that those laws become meaningful, and they are really of assistance to the people. Rules, regulations, laws, some procedures are also being revised and so on, that these facilities ought to be provided. But it is also necessary that those facilities really do become available to the senior citizens, and not only in the urban areas, in the cities, or not only to those citizens who can have an assertive voice or who are just known, but in general for the senior citizens. And this is for that very purpose that the Respect Age India International has been working. It keeps in touch with the governmental agencies, with the other organizations who are doing similar work, and thus just provide some kind of an organized strength to this movement of Respect Age India International. I would like to thank my colleagues who are in the room. They are full of enthusiasm, full of energy, full of ideas, and so on, and as to how those ideas can be put into practice or translated into action. That's what is a great quality which these gentlemen possess, and that has always impressed me. I once more like to felicitate, congratulate the senior citizens for the immense contribution in different areas, the various areas. Even if you look at the persons who have who are being honored, let us take say Mr. M.M. Sabarwa, whom I have known from the early 70s, 71, 72 onwards, and the way he worked in the different spheres of social activity, even when he was otherwise in his own professional capacity, also setting an example as to how the people should behave when they are in affluent position and in a position to do the right thing. That kind of ethics that he exhibited in his life and his duties, somehow because of his health, he is not in a position to be here today, but I certainly do. This is, and others are something, when we have very distinguished the ladies, Mrs. Radha Bhatia, who reminded me years back, almost 40 decades back, when I happened to be at Missouri, that she had met me along with her uncle, and Mr. Bhatia, a very senior colleague of mine, and this is, so it was nice meeting her. Dr. Kusum Ansar, she is a very well-known author, poetess, of very talents. So far as the latest is concerned, she has found a place for herself. I have seen some of her own the writings. Mrs. Rajni Agarwal, she is Maila Mangal and Kalpataru Society. She is the voluntary organization. Taken up a number of social activities. This is Radha Bhatia. She is a founder member of the World Travel and Tourism Council of India. Now this is also a new area, a pioneer area, in which I think she plays a pioneering role in the role which we have. Similarly, Mr. R.N. Kapotia, I have known him for also the decades. Again, we can say almost 50 years. when I happened to be a collector and district magistrate in his own district, and it has been a pleasure to see him, not only having done immense amount of work in his own professional area as a tax consultant or a chartered accountant and so on and so forth, but in promoting art, literature, culture, in helping the disadvantaged sections in society in his own way. So this is Mr. Subodh Bhargava has carved a place for himself as the chairman of the Tata Communications Limited. Mr. Narayana Das is the chancellor of the GLA University, that itself, that by itself speaks. Mr. Vikramjit Ahluwalia is the founder, promoter and CMD of Ahluwalia Contacts India Limited. I mean, these designations are indicative of the amount of work that they are doing and the responsibilities they are having. And in honoring all of them, I think the society honors itself and also presents them as examples worthy to follow by the coming generations. Thank you all very much.